Ladies and gentlemen, we have takeoff. The hover cover is being taken off the playing surface, and Glamorgan against Leicestershire is about to get underway, we hope. A mere 24 hours late, I'm Nick Webb. Alongside me is Richard Ray of BBC Radio Leicester. Some hours ago, at some point in yesterday's endless stretches, Leicestershire won the toss, and a good one to win, you feel?
It would seem that way. I can't hear myself very well.
Let's try and get rid of the hover cover.
Yes, it would seem that way. Conditions would appear to be in favour of seam bowling. It is gloomy out there. Very belated good morning to one and all. Some interesting team selections from Leicestershire's point of view. From the 13 who travelled, they have left out Ed Barnes, who bowled well in the last game, but also Rehan Ahmed, who apparently has a sore shoulder. So they have a strong batting lineup. The bowling, well, we are hoping from Leicestershire's point of view that the all-rounder Vihan Mulder is able to bowl. He would certainly strengthen that seam lineup. And as the umpires come down the steps, Nick, it gets darker and darker.
Well, we're scheduled to get underway. It is pretty murky out there, but to be honest, with the weather forecast and the light that we've had over the last 24 hours, we could be on and off as many times as you like. So Glamorgan with David Lloyd back after 8 weeks injury absence, and Michael Nisa surprisingly returned from Australia duty, one presumes just for this match, since Australia have a gap between tests, and that means that Colin Ingram misses out for Glamorgan. Now the umpires are a fair way apart in height, which is good news for your commentary team.
They are readily identifiable, aren't they, if we get that one wrong, given there is, as you say, a foot and a half difference between them. There is no excuse. The ground staff are hanging by the cover, aren't they? Looking very, very concerned up at the sky.
Well, various forecasts give various probabilities of rain, as always.
And
oh,
it's raining.
I don't believe it. The rain arrives
quite
at 10:58.
Quite hard, too. The Leicestershire players have gathered by the boundary rope and they are heading back to the pavilion pronto. The Glamorgan batters have beaten them to it. They went charging back up the steps, and that is the sound of the hover mower starting again.
You couldn't make it up. Unfortunately, we haven't made that up, and we will have the hover cover coming on. Richard will be updating BBC Radio Leicester listeners on this turn of events. I'll just run through the card of other games in the county championship to tell you what is happening elsewhere. At Durham, Gloucestershire 284-6. They were in the first over there, having played 73 yesterday. At Hove, Sussex resuming on 376-7 against Derbyshire. The scores there: Tom Clark hits 96, fellow opener Tom Haynes 86, Ollie Carter, hero of Sussex's draw here, 56, and Finn Hudson-Prentice 52, not out. So Sussex going well against Derbyshire. And at New Road, Worcestershire against Yorkshire. Yorkshire rattled up 154 for no wicket, thanks to Adam Lythe 77 and Finlay Bean 69. Here at Sophia Gardens, it is raining fairly steadily. Umpires Baldwin and Chantry on the retreat. Mr. Baldwin, the shorter of the two, the West Wales-based umpire. Jack Chantry, brother of the former Glamorgan player Adam. But a gloomy scenario at 11 o'clock as we lose more time. It was due to be 104 overs to be bowled today, but the players have been left scurrying back to the pavilion, although the umpires are proceeding rather more sedately. Well, that's because of their dignity, or because It's not raining too hard at the moment. Out in the middle, just the hover cover on at the moment. The hoses are on extended, but they haven't taken out the flaps on either side of the hover cover. There are ground staff moving around and poised for action and the direction of the umpires. In Division 1, Kent against Warwickshire. Kent bowled out for 171. Warwickshire in reply dominant at 155 for 2. Lancashire against Essex, barely play there, barely any play there. Lancashire decided, Essex won the toss, decided about their 12 for 1. They're restarting there on time by the look of it. At Northwood, Merchant Taylor's School, Northants were bowled out for 219 by Middlesex. Saib Saib top scored with 49. Wickets shared round from the Middlesex bowlers. They're 23 for naught in reply. At Taunton, looks like they're underway there today. Somerset 196 for 5 against Hampshire. James Rue 77 not out. Casey Aldridge 55 not out. And Somerset fielding a fairly experimental bowling lineup, leaving a few players out to be rested ahead of T20 finals day. Finally, at the Oval, Surrey against Notts. Surrey 339 for 8, a recovery there thanks to a century from Jordan Clark at number 7. Ben Folkes made 46 off 118 balls. That's not the way to get in the England Test team, Ben. But I'm afraid it is a sorry sight here at Sophia Gardens. The players taking to the field. And just as about they were about to cross the boundary ropes, it rained. So they're just starting to unfeel some of the sheeting from the hover cover to cover the used wicket on the side of the strip that we are using, or due to be using. And see one of the ground staff sticking on a rain jacket. So we're not going to get any immediate action, and indeed further sheeting is being rolled out from the hover cover, so it looks like they're preparing for a longer rather than a shorter delay. Yet to get underway here then at Sophia Gardens, with the players driven from the field by a shower at 10:58. We'll be back here on BBC Sport Online with Richard Ray of BBC Radio Leicester, Edward Bevan, and myself, Nick Webb of BBC Sport Wales, as soon as there's any action at Sophia Gardens. But for the moment, there's light rain falling. The light, to be honest, would not be good enough to permit play to resume. And we'll be back in due course.
water on it, didn't it?
Probably has.
Get one of them things you had last night, that will be it. Who's an Iron Fair then on match days?
I can imagine it'd be corporate, I would have thought. Yeah, it's corporate, I would have thought. That's not quick, you know.
Thank you.
I've got some further news following the inspection by the umpires. Provided there is no more further rain, they will get underway at 11:30. We have lost 8 overs, so it's 96 overs to be bowled. Weather permitting is starting at 11:30.
It's not that's the start. Cool, it's not a star.
11:25 and Glamorgan against Leicestershire. May start if there is no rain in the next couple of minutes. What drama, Richard Ray?
Well, it does look an awful lot a little bit lighter than it did at, half an hour ago when the rain came down as the umpires got out to the middle. I don't think that is going to happen this time. I can see hills away to our left and lighter clouds over the city centre. I know it's coming sort of from behind us up the Bristol Channel, the weather in this game, but fingers crossed we are going to get a little bit of play.
Yeah, the Glamorgan batters are waiting eager to get on with it. David Lloyd and Zain Ul Hassan, perhaps you'd like to run through the Leicestershire lineup before you disappear.
Yes, in approximate batting order, Rishi Patel, Sol Budinger, Peter Hanscom, Colin Ackerman, Vian Mulder, Lewis Hill, Louis Kimber, Tom Scriven, Callum Parkinson, Chris Wright and Matt Salisbury, representing the Hunting County.
And the Glamorgan side, David Lloyd, Zain Ul Hassan. Not quite sure who'll be batting at three, Sam Northeast or Kieran Carlson. Billy Root, probably promoted to five, Chris Cook, Michael Nisa, Tim van der Hoogten, James Harris, Mitch Schwepson, and Jamie McElroy. Again, in approximate batting order. And to the sound of applause from the very, very small crowd, we are getting underway, a mere 24 hours and 27 minutes late. Eight overs have been lost from the day's allocation. We expect further interruptions are fairly likely during the course of the day. Chris Wright, who took 5/89 in the team's most recent meeting in Leicester, will open the bowling. The 37-year-old, he turns 38 on Friday, and he'll be off to Sussex next season. He's wearing 31 on his back, and he'll be bowling from the Cathedral Road end. And the first ball will be taken by the left-handed Zain Ul Hassan. There are three slips. Here we are, we're getting underway at last as Wright bowls and Ul Hassan blocks it into the offside and there is no run. The action has started here at Sophia Gardens under cloudy skies. Who knows whether we'll get much more, but at least we have a match on. Though technically the match has started as soon as the teams are announced. Edward Bevan popping in alongside me for a minute or two while Richard's updating radio listeners as Wright is into Ul Hassan, who flicks it down the leg side. It's not cleanly taken by keeper Hanscom.
Lovely morning again, Nick. It's like something out of November, isn't it?
It's completely overcast. And we have had one heavy shower already. And I don't think the pitch is as bad as it may look on the screens for those of you watching on video. It's right in to bowl to Ul Hassan. That's outside off stump and through to Hanscom.
Yeah. You wonder, Nick, who's going to suffer and what an advantage it is, because Leicestershire will have to bowl with a ball that's going to get increasingly damp with all that rain we've had. And Glamorgan may have to cater with the ball wobbling about in this cloudy atmosphere, and it's rather humid, so I don't know. I'm just glad to get some cricket.
Well, it was Lewis Hill who won the toss, so Leicestershire.
Yesterday
at some point, 4 o'clock. As Ul Hassan plays that one on the leg side, and there is no run. Zain Ul Hassan has played three matches. He's accumulated 193 runs, and he's averaging 32 at the moment, albeit with a highest score of only 48. David Lloyd playing his first game in 8 weeks, on the back of the news that he's departing for Derbyshire.
when I join you later, perhaps we can have a word about that. It's hugely disappointing.
He watches from the non-striker's end and right bowls, and Al-Hassan thrusts the right pad forward, plays no shot, and it goes through to Hanscom.
Yeah.
Hello. I was about to say we start with a maiden, but it is only five balls that have been bowled, and again the players are leaving the field.
It's well, if it wasn't such a disappointment, it's laughable, because there's about a dozen spectators from supporters from Leicestershire sitting underneath us, and I feel desperately sorry for them. They've probably come down for the 4 days, and they're probably going to get, what, Thursday is a good day, Nick, to find it, yes. And that's about it.
The battle for bonus points on Thursday, and particularly disappointing given these sides are both in the shake-up for promotion, Leicestershire in second, Glamorgan in fifth, but just 11 points behind. And nearly everywhere else there's been a reasonable amount of play. Well, the hover cover's coming on, and the umpires are staying out in the,
maybe
in the middle
light,
of the moment.
Who knows?
Anyway, we will be back with you on BBC Sport Online as and when there is further action.
Thank you. Yeah.
pressure this morning raining. It's not raining now.
Where are you going, David?
Standing out
to half. Don't go halfway down and then it rains and we'll come back up.
It's got a sort of half back.
It's a good view, I think.
Yeah. I wanted to see Kelvin, the gate was just in about half half in the open. And if he works on the gate, Kelvin.
I'd have smiled, I'd have been able to call that.
Well,
oh, no, just going to school with that.
Well, last year, sorry, the times before with the bank, it's always the season ticket holders that stop charging. So you just show your season ticket card at the gate and then wade you into the field.
Where did you go on the left?
Yeah, at the top, past it. Just slightly past it.
Yeah. I think it's just some really rugged people there from the work. They probably work on the farm.
Six yards. More talent than you really.
They did give it to me.
The monsoon's on its way.
Can't you check in? Are you on the toilet?
Into the wall. You tell you about Andy Finn.
It wasn't the fact that the only reason it's still affected by the alcohol
it came in until last night. You tell you about Andy. Yeah. No one shared a room with Andy, he always leave a light on in the back.
Yeah,
sure. And I asked him, why do you always leave a light on when you come back? It's the basic story. I know you find it's hard to believe, but you do some work and you have to spend the night in the premier. And you got blotto.
Yeah.
He went to it then. And he says, the door's shut, the aren't they? And light switches on the outside.
Oh,
he says, It was half hour in the bathroom trying to get out. Which can happen, can't it? So he says, that's why I always leave a light on in the bathroom. Once you're in the door, so it's pitch black, isn't it? There's no windows, that's all right. I had visions of Andy Finney. I thought, I'm going to have to.
Same guy. Yeah, he's like, I'm going
to have to.
Where's Mr. Brown gone?
Gone to power his nose.
He's disappeared.
He's down there.
Where? Down where?
Who's Nicky Campbell?
Who's
oh,
what?
No, it's Amy.
Who's that?
Amy.
I've got some further news following the inspection by the umpires. It's been decided that an early lunch will be taken at 12:30.
I know. See, I told you that. We've seen him coming back, haven't we?
Yes, we did actually.
Yeah. So let's go down Griggs again. Door's probably shut on him, didn't ask you that.
We'll give him till they're having lunch. We'll look for him. This guy looks from that stand there.
There's more than there was yesterday. Two down there, three down there.
I thought it was about 2 days. It's
more than here. What's this? Yeah,
what did you do down here? It was. We can tell it's gone. Not like it was here yesterday. We sat down the front of the room.
He's got pneumonia.
He was there all week.
Never moved, did it? No, he didn't even rain.
No, when we went there, he came back.
He's got pneumonia today.
He's the one that put me on the challenge of the game.
Yeah, five balls.
It's down there.
Gents, sorry to be in pain. This is going to be close to public, I'm afraid.
Yeah, okay.
Sorry.
That's from now.
Huh?
That's from now.
From now, yes.
Yeah. Okay.
No, just going to go on the wires and stuff.
Yeah, that's fine.
No, thank you.
Because if we down there, it's going to be wonderful for the next 2 hours.
We are, anyway. We are. I'm going to run up there. Just come back.
Yeah, I'm seeing it.
Definitely sure what I don't know.
deserves a double breath. Yeah, the beautiful place.
Walk through the park, go over the bridge, and then we turn up on that right bit.
Yeah.
You go down to Witherspoon. There's a big hotel on that corner.
Right.
Where they are.
Yeah.
On there.
Yeah.
And
Is that it?
Don't blame me, mate. Don't blame me.
Well, it's sad, but there you go. It's like this. There's more people going to see it.
Well, there was one we first took. Yeah. I don't know where Dave would have brought it.
That Indian guy on his presentation, I haven't sat there all day yesterday, didn't he? He was there when we came in, he was there when we left. He hadn't moved.
Stop, mate. You can have to move them.
Well, it was complaining, wasn't it?
Right. They've taken the lunch at half 12 off of it now. Stop, mate. Thinking. You walk there, you go on. You walk by the other. You pay.
Yes.
I'll get the family.
Thank you. Thank you.
I've got some further news from the umpires who've just completed an inspection. The umpires will be making a further inspection at 2 o'clock. I've got some lunchtime scores from the other games where play has and hasn't been possible so far today. At Taunton, there has been a little bit of play, but there's also been a little bit of rain as well. With Somerset moving on to 326-6, that's against Hampshire. At Chesterley Street, Gloucestershire were dismissed by Durham for 316, and at lunch, Durham in reply, 98-2. It's lunch at home where Sussex were dismissed by Derbyshire for 402, and in their first innings, Derbyshire are 56-1. A delayed start at New Road. Play is now taking place at Worcester, and Yorkshire still batting in their first innings. They're 212-1. It's lunch at Merchant Taylor's School in Northwood, where Middlesex are 127-4. That's after yesterday, Northamptonshire made 219. Lunch as well at the Oval, where Nottinghamshire are 81-1. That's in reply to Surrey's first innings total of 355. They have been playing today at Blackpool after a wet day there as well yesterday. Essex, in their first innings, are currently 88-4. That's against Lancashire. Lunch there is at 1:10. Lunch at Canterbury has also seen Warwickshire move on to 271-5. That's after yesterday Warwickshire dismissed Kent for 171. And just to repeat, the umpires will be making a further inspection here at Sophia Gardens at 2 o'clock.
Thank you.
I will be honest with you, I'm sort of actually aware of the sensibility of that. Do that because it's kind of happy. You do it.
was at my London Review on Friday to speak to that. Be like, I've got a question. You can't write a friend with a guitar.
Doing it because I've missed the full half of the season. If I'd have waited the majority. Thank you.